Write the completed factored form of the polynomial in the graph below. The leading coefficient is either 1 or negative 1, and the polynomial has integer zeros. So first of all, we need to recall that there's a relationship between the x-intercepts of the graph and the factors of the polynomial. If the graph of y equals f of x has an x-intercept at k, then a factor of the polynomial is x minus k. So let's first of all identify the x-intercepts of this polynomial. The x-intercepts are at negative 4, negative 1, and 3. From the x-intercepts, we can determine the factors of the polynomial. To find each factor, we subtract the x-intercept from x. So our first factor is x minus negative 4, which simplifies to x plus 4. The second factor is x minus negative 1, which simplifies to x plus 1. And the third factor is x minus 3. To get our polynomial, we multiply the factors and the leading coefficient together. We get y is equal to a times the factor x plus 4 times the factor x plus 1 times the factor x minus 3. We're told that the leading coefficient is either 1 or negative 1. To determine which one it is, we can use the fact that the y-intercept is positive. It's hard to tell exactly what the y-intercept is, but we can tell that it's a little bit more than 10. It's clearly a positive value. So let's substitute 0 for x in our polynomial and see what value we get. We get a times the factor 0 plus 4 times the factor 0 plus 1 times the factor 0 minus 3. Well, 4 times 1 times negative 3 is negative 12, so we get negative 12a. Now we know that a is either 1 or negative 1. If a is equal to 1, then we get negative 12 times 1 is negative 12. But the y-intercept is not negative, it's positive, so that means that a cannot be 1. It must be negative 1. Negative 12 times negative 1 is positive 12, and looking at the graph, it certainly seems reasonable that our y-intercept is 12. When we substitute negative 1 for a in the polynomial, we get y is equal to negative 1 times the factor x plus 4 times the factor x plus 1 times the factor x minus 3, which simplifies to our answer in part D. To verify our answer, we can use a graphing calculator. First of all, we go to y equals to enter the equation. We enter minus the factor x plus 4 times the factor x plus 1 times the factor x minus 3. Next, we adjust our window settings. On the given graph, we see that the x values range from negative 5 to 5 with a scale of 1. So we'll change x minimum to negative 5, x maximum to 5, and x scale to 1. We see that the y values range from negative 30 to 30 with a scale of 10. So we enter negative 30 for y minimum, 30 for y maximum, and 10 for the y scale. Finally, we go to graph, and we see that the graph on the calculator screen matches the graph that's given. We have x-intercepts at negative 4, negative 1, and 3, and a y-intercept at 12.